In this video, I'm going to show you the economy module in Ongoing. You can find that in the top menu here under economy. And this feature has been designed for 3PLs or third-party logistics companies in particular to be able to correctly charge their customers. We're going to set up a price list consisting of two charges, one manual and one statistical charge. Manual charge is, as the name suggests, something that you can just put on your customer at any time, for example, an extra work hour that you did. And a statistical charge is something that the system will compute automatically for you. And in this case, we're going to check how many orders has been processed during a month. And in this case, we have sent 5 orders in the month of April, and that is what we're going to let the system compute automatically with this statistical charge. So you go to economy and then price list to set up your price list and click this button, create new charge. And let's start with the statistical charge, number of orders shipped. And it will be pieces, and we're going to charge $15 or whatever currency you're working with here for one order. And this button here, I will come back to that in the manual charge, but check this box from statistics. Now you have in this list everything that the system can compute automatically. Here is everything concerning inbound, everything concerning outbound, and then storage and pallets and so on. So we are going to take this one, number of shipped orders. And then now you have the Or first, some mentioning about the price calculation here. Here, for example, if you put in min max, you can put the min price for the month, how much you want to charge, or a max price, or if you want to give a couple of orders for free every month. And here you have a price matrix, which is good if you want to do brackets in your price list. But here you can test your charge that you have created. So if I click test here, I expect 5 times. Let's do none here and test. I expect 5 times 15, 75 for the month of April in this case. Or here I have also March, but I don't have any orders being processed then. So then let's click create. And here we have our first pricing info, and as usual, you can, of course, change these columns if you want to view something else here by clicking the settings cog down here. We are going to also create a manual charge, so let's call that extra packing material, and that will also be pieces, and let's put in 20 for this one. And this checkbox is, of course, then the possibility to add this charge manually from the scanner. So if this is checked, then you will have a checkbox in the scanner where you can see what manual charges you can put onto your customer. And then you will, of course, will have it connected to an order or purchase order if that's what you're working with in the scanner. Let's click create. And the next thing that we're going to do is creating an invoice. So then you go to economy and invoice. And here we simply click create new invoice. And let's call it April. That's the only thing that we have to put. And I will put in the dates. And then Activate here means that the invoice that will be created is active for that particular goods owner. And that means that all manual charges that you then put on will directly come onto the invoice. So let's click create here. And now we have our invoice here, and we can see if we first click calculate, then we will see those five shipped orders. But let's first add this manual charge. So the easiest way to do this from the admin interface is to go to economy and then charge. And we're going to click the plus sign on the extra packing material, and let's put one of those and then click create. Here's the date as well. And now if we go back to the invoice and click calculate here, the invoice will be calculated. And now if we check this one, invoice specification, you will see how it looks in the default appearance to your customer. Extra packing material, one piece, and it was done this date, unit price 20, and number of orders shipped, five pieces at a total of 75. So that's how you will create an invoice. Now let's also see how you could do it for another goods owner. So how to copy the price list. Just flip over to goods owner 2, your other customer, and then click this one, copy charges from another goods owner. And then you select which goods owner, and you select here which charges you want to copy. And then you simply click copy, and then you have them here for that customer. Let's say you want to have 10% higher prices for this goods owner, then you can update price with percentage, or if for the next year you want to index adjust your price, for example, you can do that, and then just put in what percent, 10%, and click update, and then you see that the unit price is now 16.5 instead. If you want to get an overview of your invoices, then you go to economy and invoicing overview. And here you will see all of your active invoices for your goods owners. Here we only have one active invoice, which is the one titled April for goods owner 1. And we don't have any invoice for goods owner 2 yet. I should also mention that you can automatically create your invoices if you have many different customers, for example, and you want to create an invoice automatically a specific date. This is possible. I refer to our docs pages on that. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much.